Yeah, hi everyone. Am I audible to all of you? If any one of you has a problem, they can chat me. Okay, so we are going to start this session for the manual testing. In another 1 minute, we will wait 1 more minute for anyone who is joining. Okay, so we will start with the session now. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about software testing. Okay, so prerequisite for this training is actually there is no technical requirement from your side that you should know this tool or that tool. Okay, so I just need your attention and a lot of interaction during the course of the training. Okay, so before starting this session, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Chanmalleshwar Shukla. I am working as a tech lead in one of the CMI level company based out in Bangalore. Okay, so I have around 8 years of software testing experience, out of which I have worked on API testing, manual testing, automation testing, performance testing. Okay, so there are different kinds of tools available for automation testing, API testing, performance testing. But before starting with any of those things, you need to understand the basics of software testing itself. Okay, so I will try to keep your acquaintance with all the keywords and everything which are there in the software testing today. Okay, can be your career path in software testing, how you can switch from one type of testing to another type of testing. All these things you will get to know during the course of the training today. Okay, so we will start with the introduction. What is actually the software testing? To start with any topic, I believe we need to understand three basic things of it. What it is actually, why that particular thing is important, and how we can do it. So these are the things I am going to discuss today. If you have any doubt, you can always raise your hand or chat me. I will try to clarify that doubt then and there. If I will believe that this is the question that I am going to discuss in the course of the testing discussion, then I will let you know. Okay. Okay. So we will start with what is software testing? Before actually starting, what is software testing? I would like to ask what is actually testing. Let's forget about software terminology in next 2 3 minutes. We will discuss what is testing. Okay, so any product, be it any kind of product, be it medical device, be it laptop, be it any accessory that we all of us use. Before coming to the market, there are certain types of testing which are done on each and every product. Okay, so you must be seeing this product is ISO certified. There are various organizations who certify all the products and everything. What they do basically? They basically do the testing of that product. Okay, so testing is what? Testing, if I say in not a technical term but in informal term, testing is to make sure that whatever you are creating is of great quality. Okay, process. So software testing is also, it is a process to make sure that your product, the software product which you are making, is of great quality. Okay, it is a process, it is a continuous process. It is not like you, once we are doing and after that we are not going to do anything like that. Software testing is a continuous process. I will, in the course of the training, I will tell you how software development life cycle works. Okay, so there you will realize software testing is the integral part of each and every development life cycle, each and every step of development life cycle. Okay, so I'll repeat, what is software testing? Software testing is the process to make sure that the product is great. I will repeat, this is not the actual definition which you will find anywhere in the book. The another term which can be said for it is, it is a practice that makes sure that the functions are working fine. So any software you are making, it is supposed to do certain kinds of functions. Okay, suppose I am creating a something like, if I take the example, something similar to Facebook application I am creating. So application, Facebook application has some of the functions: login functions, search friends function, add friend function, write on your walls function. So these all are functions. So what is software testing? Software testing is the practice that makes sure all these functions are working fine for the users. Okay, another definition of is, it is an idea to enhance the user experience. Okay, I will emphasize on this word idea here. Okay, so when we create a software, there are certain plans for it. Okay, I am going to create this which should do certain functionality. Suppose I take the example of search functions only on your Facebook, Insta, Twitter, anything. There are search functionality present there. Okay, so if I am searching there, you must be seeing the autocorrect comes. Okay, so the autocorrect is an idea which could which software testing people generates those kinds of idea while creating any software. It is not like everything is defined in the document and the software is built on that. What software you see as an end product, it is a continuous effort from the development team, business team, and most importantly, the testing team. The testing team makes sure that the product is very good for the end users. So as a software tester, your whole aim is going to be make sure that the end users are having the very good user experience when they are using the product. Okay, so software testing is also a part of SDLC that gives you the confidence on the product being made. Okay, so what is SDLC? What are the different phases of it? We will discuss it in the course of time. Okay, so you can see like software testing is basically a part of SDLC as well. When I will tell you all the SDLC diagrams and everything, then there is one important phase for software testing. Okay, so software testing is actually a part of SDLC that gives you confidence that the product that you are creating, users are going to find it very good to use. Okay, if anyone has any doubt on it till now, they can ping me. I will try to clarify it. Now comes the actual definition of software testing. If you will see the actual definition of software testing on the what ISTQB defines. I will tell you what ISTQB is during the course of this demo session only. Okay. So software testing is the process to evaluate the functionality of a software application with an intent to find whether the developed software met the specified requirement or not, and to identify the defects to ensure that the product is defect free in order to produce the quality product. There may be various keywords in these definitions which you will not be finding it comfortable right now, and that is completely fine. Okay, but few of the things I would like to discuss here. Something like functionality, I already told you what is functionality and how it works. Okay. Specified requirements, defects, these are the keywords that you will learn in the course of the training. What are defects? What is the specified requirement? How it works? What is defect? What is defect? Can anyone tell me using the chat window? Or if anyone want to speak, I will unmute them. What is defect? So I have got an answer. An issue in the software. Srinivas says it is an issue in the software. Hemlata says error in the code. I would like to have more answers here. We'll wait for another 30 seconds for more answers. Faulty. Lazy Addo says faulty. Okay. Deviation between expected and actual. Okay. Harinder says. Aditya says bug in the software that may be related to code, etc. Okay. Mohit says failure in the application. Okay. So all these definitions are actually correct. Okay. So what actually is defect? Few people write here defect in the code. Okay. So defect is not only related to the code, first of all, it can be related to the requirement also. Okay. Whatever the requirement was being made for the software, that is also maybe not correct. Okay, so defect can come from there also. Of course, it will come from the errors in the code, it will come from the errors in the document as well, which the developers are developing, and it can come from the altogether the wrong requirement gathering. Whatever requirement gathering happened from the business team itself was not correct. Okay, so we have a different criteria for having the bug or defect in the system. Okay, so we will discuss all of them one by one during the course of the training. I hope I am clear with what actually is software testing. Okay, so I think I'm clear with it because I haven't got any related query on this now. We are going to switch to why software testing is important now. Okay. So why software testing? We discussed what is software testing. Now we are going to do why software testing is important. Okay. Few of the ideas we got in the first slide itself, why software testing is important. That were to make sure that the product is of very good quality, right? And another thing was that it meets the requirement. Okay, so those were the specification that is important from the business point of view. So why software testing is important? Because developers and business analysts are humans. What I mean by this statement, can anyone in the group can ping on the chat to get to know why, what is the meaning of this statement? Because developers and business analysts are humans. I gave the fair bit of idea of this in the first slide itself during the, when we were discussing it 2 minutes back. So can someone tell me what is the meaning of this statement? Because developers and business analysts are human. I think I have got the answer. Let's see. Human makes error. That is very good. Funny Kumari says human makes error. They make mistake in the requirement understanding. And Radha says that is correct. Okay. Correct. So both these answers are correct. Okay. So whenever we are creating any kind of requirement specification or the developers are developing the code, okay, there are high chances that they will commit some error. Okay. So to make sure that those errors are not going to the end customers, the software testing becomes very, very important. Okay. In the SDLC, the software testing is as important as the development phase. Okay. So just like developers are humans, business analysts are humans. So the testing, what people are doing actually the testing. So they are actually the human as well. Okay, so they are also supposed to commit the mistake. How to reduce that kind of mistake as well, that we will also discuss during the course of training. It's not an ideal world. Okay, what is the meaning of this statement? You guys must be thinking at that it is related to the first statement itself. Somewhere it is related, but there is more of it. Okay, so I will explain it. It's not an ideal world. What I want to say by this thing. Suppose you created a software, right? So the developer who was working on it, okay. So right through the development cycle, he worked only on, okay. So Hafiza said you cannot always get what you want to think. That's correct. Okay, so I'll resume. So suppose developer is creating a software. During the course of the development, all through the time he worked only on Linux machine without thinking that the end users will start using this particular software more on Mac or Windows. Okay, so before starting the development, he made an assumption that this software should work only on Linux machine. All the specification, all the requirement that were gathered by the business team. Okay. So everything is working perfectly on Linux machine. But once the software is installed on the Windows, it crashes. So that's what, it's not an ideal world. Whatever assumption you have made in the beginning, it is not always going to work. Correct? So we need to make sure that we have someone in the team who is thinking out of the box. Okay, so there comes the importance of software testing. As a software tester, you should always think out of the box. Don't just rely on the requirement document. Don't just rely what developers are telling you to test. To be a good software tester, you should always be a very good user. Okay, if you are a very good user of any application, you are going to test it very thoroughly. Okay, all the use cases and the scenarios will come to your mind on your own if you are taking that product as an end user. Okay. Another point is customers are king. Of course, the customers are king. That's why each and every company is spending a lot of dollars on the software testing professionals. The market for software testing professionals is growing day by day because of the competition in the market. For one kind of product, you have n number of applications available, be it social media, be it banking, be it microfinancing, be it customer relationship management tool. For one kind of requirement, you have at least 50 kinds of product available with you. Yes or no? Okay. So it's up to customers now what they are going to use. And what customers will use? Customers will use those things which are easy to use, which are user friendly, which they are finding a lot of interest to use with. I will take the example of social media, because every one of us is on social media right now. Going forward, I will take a lot of examples of banking application and CRM and other applications also. I will take the examples of, but right now let's take the example of again the social media one. Why few of the social medias are so popular and other social media applications doesn't have many users with them? What can be the reason behind it? The same kind of developers are working on it. If you see the designs and everything on all the social media, you will find similar kind of thing. You can put up the story, you can make a friend, you can chat with a friend, you can post your photos. So why is it like two or three social media platforms are very, very popular, the other social media platforms are not popular? What is the reason behind it? Someone says user friendly, right? Usability, okay. User experience. So user experience is one of the keywords that we are getting from most of the people in the class. That is actually very good. So what makes the user friendly? What makes any software user friendly? My next question is going to be that. User friendly means your application is easy to use. It is bug free. Okay. And on all the, we have different kinds of platforms available. Okay. We are using social media from desktop. We are using social media from our mobile phones, from our tablets. In mobile phones also, we have Android, we have iPhone. So on each and every platform, if any application is working fine, then that is basically the definition of this small word, easy to use, which many of the people are saying, user friendly. When any software will become user friendly, when I'm able to use it on Android phone, iPhone, desktop seamlessly, okay, on each and every platform, the behavior of the application should be same, irrespective of all the hardware specifications that are different on all these platforms. So that makes the software testing very, very important, and that's why the software testing is in demand all around the world, be it any startup, be it the well-defined CMI level MNCs, be it any new product that is coming to the market. The software testing becomes very, very important part of each and every applications that is being made. I hope I am clear with this statement, customers are king, right? Diversified users. I think we already covered the diversified users part in this. Okay, diversified users means we are using it on Android phone, we are using it on Linux, we are using it on Windows based application, we are using it on Mac. And also diversified users, I would like to add here, People are using it in different parts of the world. The world is a small village now. Okay, there are no kind of products which are created for any country specific these days. All the products which are there in the market, it is for everyone. It is for all around the world. Of course, most of the products. I'm not talking about banking products or customer relationship management products. I'm discussing about the general products which are available in the market. So they are available all through the world. Different age groups are working on it. Okay. The requirement for someone who is 30 years old can be different from the requirement of someone who is 60 years old. Okay. Again, the requirement of the person who is working out in Asia can be different from the requirement of the people who are based out in US. Or Africa. Okay, so any kind of software you are creating or any kind of mobile applications you are creating, it has a diversified users these days. So who is going to think out of the box for these diversified users? These are the software testing people. Okay, so I will reiterate why software testing is so much important for any of the company right now. Okay, I hope I'm clear with this. Okay, now we will come to again very important point, how to do software testing. We discussed what, I hope I'm clear in that. We also discussed why. I got a lot of chat pings for why also. So I think everyone is clear on why also. Now we are going to discuss how software testing can happen. Okay. If you have any doubt till now, please ping me on the chat window. Okay, fine. So I hope we are clear with right now. We will discuss now how. So how software testing can happen. Of course, we have manual testing, database testing, automation testing, API testing, performance testing. So I'm going to discuss these things one by one. Okay. So what is actually manual testing? Manual testing is the most important part of any kind of testing that you can do. Okay, I will tell you why. Manual testing is just making sure that your application is working fine by working on it manually. We are not doing any kind of automation right now. We are not doing any kind of database query or anything like that. While doing the manual testing, you have to work as an end user. We discussed a lot of things on why software testing is important, and I tried to cover all the points in very detailed manner just to make sure that when we discuss the manual testing, you guys are fine with why manual testing has so much of importance in the age of API testing, performance testing, automation testing. Because while checking anything as a manual tester, you will behave like an end user. Okay, so while behaving like an end user, many ideas will come to you which are not there in the requirement document. Actually, no one has thought on it. Okay, so as a manual tester, you will do a lot of things that end users are going to do, a lot of stupid things even, I will say. Okay, suppose I'm logged in into any application. Okay, by mistake I have deleted that application. Okay, it was not intended from me that I will delete, but while clearing all the cache and all the useless applications from my mobile phone, I also ended up deleting that application. So these out of box ideas will come to you when only you will do the manual testing. Okay. What will happen if I reinstall that application? How it should behave? If I was already logged in into that application, I had so many friends, I had so many photos on that, a lot of photo backups were created. How it is going to behave if I will reinstall that? Again, if I don't want to reinstall it on my mobile phone because my memory is going down now, how it will behave now when I am logging into using the same credentials on the desktop? These kind of ideas will come to your mind when you will do the manual testing, when you will work as an end user. Suppose I want to use it in any of the localized language. I don't want to use the by default English language. If you guys are aware, each and every application these days comes with localization. What is the meaning of localization? Is it will support your local language as well. Okay, so how it is going to behave in a localized manner? Okay, so all these things we will get to know when we will do manual testing. Okay, what happens if I will again take the example of any mobile application only. What will happen if I have used the maximum RAM of my mobile phone? I have 4GB mobile phone. I have started my application when 3GB was already in use. Okay, so how my application is going to behave? Is it going to crash? Or is it going to give me some kind of error message related to my mobile phone? I will take the another example. I have only 1% mobile battery which is remaining in my mobile phone. Okay, and I'm on the payment gateway right now. I'm about to make a payment of some dollars from Amazon, say. Okay, so, but I have only 1% battery. My battery is going to die. So what Amazon can do actually, how it can read from my device and can send me an alert that your mobile battery is about to die, please put it on charge before making payment. So all these kinds of ideas will come to your mind when you will be doing manual testing. Manual testing is all about thinking out of the box. Okay, of course it is the building block for the automation testing as well. Automation testing is basically meant for what you are going to test again and again. Okay, you are going to decrease that work from automation. That's why automation testing is also very, very important. Okay, I don't want to test each and every kind of scenario again and again. Suppose today I tested one scenario for my application. Tomorrow I don't want to test the same kind of scenario manually. So what I will do with that? I will automate it. Okay, because tomorrow I am not going to repeat my task. Automation testing is meant for making sure that whatever task you are doing, you are not going to repeat it. First time you are creating a script, you are executing it. Okay, then you need to make sure that that particular script is going to get executed every day to make sure that yes, this particular scenario is working fine. All these kinds of testing, be it manual testing, database testing, automation testing, API testing, or performance testing, they are not competitor of each other. Okay, they basically complete each other. You need to understand the database testing as well, the API testing as well, performance testing as well, manual testing and automation testing is the, of course, the most important parts of the testing profile. All these kinds of testings are as important as the other one. Out of these five, if you will ask me to choose only one, because Right now we are in the session of manual testing. So I will not say no, manual testing is the most important thing. You should not do automation testing, API testing or performance testing. I'm not going to say that. Okay, because all these types of testing complement each other. Testing is itself a full stack profile. Just like we have UI developers, we have backend developers. Okay, we have database developers. Okay. Similarly, we have manual testing guys, database testing guys, automation testing guys, API testing guys, performance testing guys. And you need to be good in all these things to be a very good QA member of the team, quality analyst. That we say quality analyst. Okay. Anyone has any doubt till now, please ping me. I'm sure you will be having some doubts on these slides. I'm going to discuss more on this right now, on all these types of testing, but I want some of the questions from your side also. Harry is asking me what is an API. I will tell you, Harry, that during the course of time. What is the functional testing and non-functional testing? We will discuss it, Avni. Accessibility, performance, Yogesh. I don't know you are telling it or asking it. Yes, accessibility, performance, these kinds of testings are also there. For manual database testing is separate. Yes, it is actually a different thing. I will tell you how during the course of the training. Will you cover database testing and API testing also? Yes, I'm going to cover the API testing using the Postman. Okay, and database testing SQL, I will completely cover. Before manual testing, what the documents or steps are needed? Nothing is needed, Srinivas. I'm going to start everything from the scratch. Nothing is needed from your side. What should be the sequence to learn all these testing types? Hafiz asks, which I think this is a very valid question. Yeah, I will tell you. Difference between sanity and smoke, Kirti. I will tell you, Kirti, these are parts of the training. We will come to these during the course of the training. Someone is asking me the syllabus. I will tell you what we are going to cover. Okay, so I got a lot of questions from all of you, which tells all of us are attentive in this discussion. Okay, so, and we are on the right path. So we will resume our discussion actually. So one of the things which I got from many of the chats is, what is API testing? Okay. So I will not be going into technical detail today in anything, but I will tell you how, what is API testing and why it is in demand these days. Okay. When we were discussing why, okay, then I told you about various kinds of platforms that are available. We have desktop, we have mobile phone. In mobile phone also, we have Android, we have Mac, we have iPhone. Okay. Mac is there for the desktop, right? When we have Windows. So what happens now, application has to behave with different kinds of platforms. Okay, so how they are interacting now? They are now interacting with API. Okay, API is basically application programming interface. Okay, there is single API which gets hit when I'm logging with mobile phone, or I'm logging with desktop, or I'm logging with Mac. There is one and only one API which is getting hit in the server for the application. Okay, so that is basically the API. And why API testing is so important is this, because of diversified users on the platforms. Okay, if one of your API is working fine, then you will have some sort of confidence that yes, if this API is working fine, so on various platforms my software is going to work according to its behavior. Okay, so API testing is about that. I will discuss during the course of the training, we will be discussing the API testing. We will have two classes for the API testing only. Okay, so API testing is also very, very important kind of thing. I also got in the questions, what is smoke testing? What is sanity testing? Those things we will cover during the course of the training. Okay, what is smoke? What is sanity? What is functional testing? What is non-functional testing? All these keywords and everything we will cover during the course of the training. Okay. Someone is asking me to elaborate more on the API testing. Okay. So for the introduction purpose, I think I told what API testing is. Okay. But if you have more doubt on it, Harry, you can ping me separately. I will tell you. Okay. What actually is API testing and how it works. Okay. Someone is asking for the ISTQB certification. Yes, I'm going to give all the terms of ISTQB certifications for you. All the kinds of interview questions that will be asked in the all these things and the CV path also, all I will tell you in those things. I'm coming to those points as well. Just have some sort of patience. I'm coming to what we are going to do during the course of the training. Okay. So I think I'm clear with these things. Manual testing, database testing, someone asked me SQL and all those things. That is very good of you. Automation testing, of course, we are in the demo from way to automation, right? So with Raman sir, you are not far behind in the automation testing. No one is better than him to tell about the automation testing. Okay, if I will find me good enough, I will also tell some fair bit of idea. I will also give about automation, those people who don't know. Okay. Now we will come to career path in software testing. I am going to discuss what I am going to give. All the people are asking me for the notes, for the resume building. These things I'm going to cover, but I will come in this demo session also what we are going to do. If you will have more doubts there, if you need more things, it is better that you chat on that particular discussion so that I can note it down. What is the requirement from your side? Okay. So now we will come to career path of software testing. Okay. What you can do actually in the software testing in IT industry. Okay. Test architect, you can become. You can become project manager. You can become automation expert. You can become performance expert. You can become QA QC expert. Okay. So I will take it one by one. Okay. So when you are starting your career, okay, maybe we are less than 2 years of experience and everything. Then we are a junior tester. Okay. At that point of time, we need to learn each and everything, whatever I told you about: manual testing, automation testing, database testing, API testing, performance testing. When we are going to tell this thing, test analyst, when we are starting our career as a junior tester, until test analyst, we need to have the fair bit of ideas of all these things. What is manual testing? What is automation testing? How to do manual testing? How to do automation testing? How to do API testing? How to do performance testing? We need to have the idea of all these things. Okay. Then at around 5 years, 6 years of experience, people generally become QA lead of any particular type of testing. Maybe you are the QA lead of manual testing because you are now the expert in manual testing. Any kind of application I am giving, you are able to think about what kind of manual testing can happen on this application. Okay, and what is the requirement? What actually are the end users for this application? I am having all these ideas and I'm able to help my teammates in all these things. At that point of time, you will become QA lead. Okay, being a QA lead doesn't mean I'm the QA lead of only manual testing, so I will know about manual testing only. It is not like that in the industry these days. You should know about the automation testing also. You should have the idea of performance and API testing as well. Okay. In today's world, when the competition in each and every field is so high, for the QA members, manual testing and automation testing is the minimal requirement. Okay. You should know about the manual testing completely. You should know about the automation testing completely. And you should have the fair bit of ideas in the other domains as well. Okay. Okay. So when you will become QA lead, you should have the fair bit of ideas of all these kinds of testing that happens. And you should be expert in any one or two of these. Of course, I said manual and automation testing is the minimal requirement. Then you will become, maybe you will become test architect. What basically test architect does? Can anyone knows about it? What test architect does? Okay, so I think we have an answer here. Designing, correct. Helps and building the frameworks, correct. So test architect are the people who create the frameworks. Okay, so if any new requirement is coming, okay, you have to create a framework for right from the scratch. Framework is not only for the automation testing, just to clarify. You can create a framework is basically the overall design. Okay, in automation testing we call what we call framework as. Framework we call like this is hybrid framework, this is data driven framework, those kinds of things we say in automation testing. But framework is basically creating an overall design. You can create a framework in performance testing. For API testing also you can create a framework. While doing manual testing also you can create a test plan, requirement traceability matrix, all these things you can create. Okay. So these are the responsibilities of test architect. Okay. And if you will believe me, these are the project managers, test architect, automation experts, project performance experts. These all are very highly paid job in the industry these days. I'm not just because I'm taking the session of manual testing. So I will not only say only you will get on very good career path only in project management or become a QA QC expert. I will tell what is the meaning of QA and what is the meaning of QC. So I will not say you will become very good. You will get very good paid only in becoming a QA or QC expert or becoming a project manager. In all these profiles, if you have the expertise in any of these things, 6 years down the line, you will be in very highly paid job. QA people these days, testing people these days are getting paid as much as developers. Okay. The reason I already told you. Okay. Because of the competition in the market for the applications, for all the applications which are available. We need expert QAs these days. So the career path of QA people are at par with the development people. In some sense, it is better than development people. Okay, because from the QA people, if you have a very good communication skill, analytical skill, you can think about the end users very well. You will easily become project manager. Okay, because the basic requirement to become a project manager is understanding your is understanding your end user. If I'm handling a project, I should understand what this project is going to do and who are its end users. Okay, so being a QA member makes you in a very good domain to become a project manager for any particular project. Okay, I'm getting a lot of questions. What are QA and Q6? But I'm coming to that point. I'm coming to each and every point. Test architect, I already explained. Project manager, I'm explaining right now. Then I will come to automation expert, performance expert, and I will also come to QA, QC expert. There is some reason why I have put it at the bottom, so that it can gather the interest of people. Okay, and there is some, I will tell you why it is important and what it is actually. Okay. So I think I'm clear with these things. Who are test architect, who are project managers? Okay, fine. I think I'm clear. Then becomes the automation expert. Of course, we have different automation tools available right now. The most important and the most popular these days is Selenium. I think we are already aware of what Rahul sir is doing in that. Okay, so if you have any queries for what Selenium is and what is a career path in automation expert, you can ping me or you can ping on our email ID. We will tell you about it. Automation experts are in demand these days as much as project managers and other architects and everything. Actually, this automation expert and test architect profiles are very much related to each other, because both of them create framework and everything for your projects. Okay, so after that comes the performance testing, performance expert. You know of the tools of JMeter or BlazeMeter is also there. We have different types of performance tools which are available. So what performance testing basically does, if you have very large number of users, we have millions of users are going to hit your particular website at same amount of time. Okay, then how your website is going to behave, how your mobile application is going to behave, those kinds of things basically performance testing people do. Again, this is very, very popular profile right now in the software testing. Okay, so there are a lot of people who want to become the performance expert, but before becoming the performance expert or any kind of these things, you should know all the terminology and everything. So manual testing basically acts as the building block of all these things. Okay. So then comes I'm getting a lot of questions. What is the difference between Q and QC? Does anyone know? Can they ping on the chat window? What is QA? What is QC? Okay, someone ping finally. Quality control, quality analyst, Srinivas says that's correct. So I wrote this word very knowingly, QA and QC. I wanted to discuss on this. Okay, quality assurance. Someone says, Aditi is saying, QA means quality assurance, QC means quality control. What is the difference between these two, Q and QC? Well, because right now it looks they are very similar. Okay, Harinder says QA involves the process oriented activity and QC is the product oriented. Okay, fine. See, quality check and the quality assurance, both are very, very different things. Okay, quality assurance comes at each and every phase of software development. Just give me 5 seconds. Yeah, so Quality assurance means making sure that each and every phase of software development life cycle, okay, right things are happening. Okay, what is the meaning of right thing? Correct. Harinder says activities in QA like inspection, review, walkthrough, and QCV product actually. Correct, Harinder. So in quality assurance, in each and every phase, we do certain kind of testing. I will not wait for the product to be created to start testing it. While from the client, I'm gathering the information as a QA member, I will sit with business analyst people and I will make sure that whatever requirement is coming to me, that itself is correct. Maybe client is not able to think from the perspective what quality assurance people can think of. Similarly, while creating a document, I'm going to help BA people to make sure that they are creating right kind of document. And of course, in the testing phase, I will do the actual testing. So quality assurance people becomes the part of the development life cycle as soon as the meeting with the client is scheduled. Okay. So QA people these days are very, very important. They start thinking like an end user right from the scratch. As soon as the idea of the product comes to my mind, what my QA expert is going to do, my QA expert is going to do this end user, is going to do these 10 things. Is your product feasible enough to handle these kinds of things? Then only create a product, otherwise don't create. So what it will help in? It will help in cost saving in the initial phase only. Okay, in initial phase, quality assurance person is going to tell me customers are going to think in this particular way for this product. Okay, so you should design properly. If you are not able to design, dump this idea. So quality assurance person is going to save my cost in the first phase itself. That I am not sure if you guys are realizing it or not, but it is actually a huge, huge cost saving. Okay. I haven't spent a penny on the business analyst people or the developers. And I'm telling what are the requirement from the customers which can come to this product. It is a huge, huge cost saving. So that is basically the role of QA expert. Okay, what is QC expert? Quality control. Okay, quality control comes during the testing phase only. Okay, what kind of testing is happening? If the customer's requirement is that they are going into log into the system 100 users at a time, so that is possible or not? Okay. If I am doing the testing, I'm doing it on correct platform. Okay, so these are the roles of QC expert. So these quality analyst or quality controller are two different kinds of things. Okay, so both of these things are very, very important. Okay, so you can become that as well in your career path of software testing. Okay, when you are starting your career and up to 5-6 years, all you have to focus on is to keep on learning different kinds of testing. Okay, I'm not saying you learn only automation testing, learn only manual testing, learn only API testing. No, it is not like that. When you will go to the Google and you will try to search what kind of testing is in demand in the market these days. One or two keywords you will get. Automation testing using Selenium is in demand. API testing using Rest Assured is in demand. But those are the people who already are experts. When you are starting your career, you should know all these kinds of testings. Then only you will get to know what is your area of interest. Okay. Okay. when you will learn, then you will get to know what is your area of interest. Then you will be able to choose the right correct path for you. Okay, what is in demand in the market is one thing, and what actually you love to do is the another thing. Okay, so you should learn each and every kind of testing, then build a confidence from there. What is your career path is going to be, and actually then you can become an expert of it. Okay. Someone is asking me, quality analyst and quality assurance is same. Harry is asking me this. Actually, Harry, quality analyst is a kind of profile and quality assurance is a practice. Quality analyst is a person who is doing the quality assurance of the software. Okay. So that's how it is related. So because we were discussing a lot of technical terminology and everything in the last two slides, I thought I will present with you one very interesting kind of picture here. Can you guys see and give me a fair bit of idea what is the what I'm trying to tell from this kind of this picture? Okay, I'm expecting some kind of questions on this on the chat window through this picture, if you can see. Aditya says developers create code and testers try to find the coverage of the code and report back to the developer if something is not right. Okay. Correct. Correct, right, Aditya. So what is basically now the difference between the development people and the testing people? Okay. Someone asked me during the first slide, what is the requirement from our side? What we actually need to know before starting this training? Okay. Actually, you don't need to know anything. You just need to come here as a part of discussion. You have to do a lot of things, okay? And you, of course, you have to interact a lot. That I'm very happy people are interacting a lot in this class. We have to keep this motto up during the course of the training as well. So that's the only requirement. The only requirement which software testing people has, while looking at the software, you just have to think, how can I break it? Okay, that's the only requirement from your side to be a very good software tester. You should think when this software is going to break. Okay. Okay. Suppose if the developer says in this text window, 2 + 2 should come as 4. Okay. That is the only thing they are telling. That is the only thing which is mentioned in the requirement gathering. 2 + 2 is equal to 4. Right. As a software tester, I will tell you many things that you can do to test this simple text box. Okay. What I can do? 2 + 2 is equal to 4. That is fine. That is in one way your software should work. What will happen if I will do numeric 2 + alphabetical 2? Then how my software is behaving? Are you getting my point? What I mean to say, developer has told you 2 + 2 is equal to 4. My text boxes should behave in this way. I am saying how my software will behave if I am doing 2 + 2. Okay, I will see how it is going to behave. How it is going to behave when 2 + 22 I am doing. All these kinds of things I will tell you. This is something I will, equivalence class partitioning, boundary value analysis, a lot of techniques you will get to know during the course of the training. So the basic difference between software tester and a software developer is software developer always say things, how I can make a software. Okay, and while thinking like this, how to make a software, he will make n number of errors. And if those n number of errors goes to the market, okay, your application is going to crash in the first day itself. That's why software testing is very, very important. What you see as an end product, that actually is not a reality. Okay, when software is being created, there are various errors present in it. Okay, so as a software tester, you have to make sure that when it goes to end customer, there are no errors which are present in the application. Now coming to the most popular thing which people were asking, what we are going to do in the course of training. Okay, so these are the things we are going to do. Okay, manual testing complete coverage should be there. I came to know what is smoke testing, what is functional testing, what is sanity testing, what is functional testing, what is non-functional testing. And believe me guys, these all are interview questions. Even if you are going for the automation interview, then these kinds of questions will be asked from you. What you will do to smoke test the application? And if you don't know what is the smoke testing, what you will do in the automation test. Okay, so all these kinds of concepts, smoke testing, sanity testing, functional testing, regression testing, non-functional testing, okay, UI testing, end user testing, system acceptance testing, user acceptance testing, all these things we will discuss in this curriculum. Okay, and of course I will tell about API testing also. API testing using manual testing. I am getting questions for the Jira. Yes, Jira looks very popular these days. If Jira is the part of our software testing training. Okay, demo project I will be creating on the Jira. I will tell you how Jira works, how you can create a story, how you can create a bug, everything I am going to tell in Jira. Okay, so I know Jira is very popular, and I will cover that. It is a part of this slide also, if I will go. Okay, please keep on pinging guys on the chat, just like the way you are doing. Okay, it is making this session very interactive, and I'm having a lot of interest while interacting with all of you. Please keep on pinging. Whatever doubts you have, whatever things you want to be included in the class, please include it. Okay, so I will resume. Manual testing complete coverage will be there, including all kinds of terminology and everything which you guys asked during the course of the training and way beyond that. Okay, API testing I will be covering, what API testing is. Complete session will be there for API testing. Okay, I will tell you about the semi automation through this as well, through using Postman, how we can execute the API testing and everything. Okay, so these things I will tell you. From the demo I got to know most of us are not clear with what actually is API. So I will start from the API, then I will go into API testing, then I will go to the tool of the API testing. Okay, database testing or basics also I will cover. SQL, all the queries and everything I am going to cover in this training. Okay, while going for the interview, you will be asked a lot of SQL queries as well. How you can update the table, how you can delete from the table, how you can create a table, all these things you will be asked during the interview. So those kinds of things I'm also going to cover. So automation testings, of course, basics only I will cover, Selenium. And I think many people are there already enrolled in the Selenium class, and those who don't are not enrolled, after this session you will be more motivated to get yourself enrolled into the Selenium training. That I can guarantee. agile methodology. When I say agile methodology, then of course it covers Jira. Okay, Jira I'm going to cover end to end, how you create a issue in the Jira, how you can create a bug in Jira, all these things I'm going to cover. Don't worry about it. Those people who are pinging me for the tools. So Jira was already part of the thing that was there. I wanted to know the interest of the people. That's why I didn't put Jira in the beginning of the slide. Okay, Jira is already part of your curriculum. Jira is there, Bugzilla is there, Postman is there. Of course, Selenium will be there. Selenium basics, I will try to cover. During the last phase of the training, you will have one session for the Selenium itself. Okay, if you are already not enrolled in the Selenium class. Okay. Apart from this, whatever is not mentioned in this curriculum, I'm going to help you in your CV building. Of course, CV building is not something I have mentioned here because every person's CV requirement will be different. So during the course of training, I'm going to share my Skype ID, email ID, everything with you. I'm going to help you on your CV building as well, how you can create your CV in a better way. Okay. And of course, I got a question during the course of training, ISTQB dump. That also we are going to give you. ISTQB dump, and during the course of training, when I will be discussing that particular topic, I will also tell you how interviewer asks you the questions related to that. Okay. So ISTQB dump is a part of the training, right? So you will get that. Okay. So yeah, ISTQB dump, your CV building, interview questions, these all will be a part of the training, and you will be getting the recording of the session for your reference. Suppose you are not able to cover the part of it or something like that, you will get it as a recorded session. That is for sure. Okay. And apart from it, any help required from you guys, I will be available on Skype. You can ping me anytime. Okay. So as soon as I will see your ping and I will find myself comfortable to answer that question, I'm going to tell you about it. Okay. You are going to receive a recording of each session. And I will also, all these presentations and everything which I'm giving right now, the keywords, all these things I will give you as a dump. Okay. Apart from it, interview questions, the study material, all these things we will try to provide. Okay. During the course of the training. Right, guys? I hope I'm clear with all your queries. And I'm very happy that all of you interacted so much during the course of training. Okay, so we are going to start this session from next Saturday at the same time, 10 a.m. IST. And other details, of course, I think you guys are already in touch with Rahul sir. So he will give you all the other details that is required from our side. Okay, so from next Saturday, we are starting this session. Okay, so all other details, what are today's recording session, or the other requirements which are there. Actually, there is no requirement from your side. I don't want you to install any software or anything like that before coming to the session. So this recording session and all the other details, Rahul sir is going to send you through email. Okay. Duration of this course is going to be like what we are planning, 5 or 6 weeks. Okay. Depending upon how much we interact during the course of the training. Today's audience was great. That goes without saying. So the material which will be there will be around 1 hour 30 minutes each day, and of course we will be getting a lot of questions which I will be answering during the course of the session or at the end of the session. So those things, considering all those aspects, we will be having the 2 hour session each day, Saturday and Sunday. Okay, so that was it about how much is the course duration. I'm getting a lot of queries on that. What is the course duration? Okay. So it is going to be like that. 6 weeks is to say. After that also, I will assure you, if you guys are having problem during your CV building, you are going to interviews, you are getting new questions, am available for everyone. Okay. After we complete 6 weeks also, I will keep on helping you guys in your queries. If you are sitting with the ISTQB certification exam, you need more help from my side through Skype or everything, I'm always ready for the quick call. Okay. I think you guys are already, if you guys are aware of Raman sir, I took the training from him 6 years back. that is long time. But still, if I ping him something for the Selenium or any kind of queries I have, he's always available. So that kind of thing that we want to implement in Way2 Automation, and I will try to carry forward that kind of legacy he has maintained for his students. Okay. So even after 6 weeks, you guys don't believe that after 6 weeks I'm not available for you guys. Of course, the active session will be there for 2 hours every day, Saturday and Sunday. But for your queries, and for if you are going to sit in any interview, you want to interact with me for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, I'll be more than happy to help you. Okay. So these things, Aditya Raman sir will be able to help you if you regarding certificate and everything. Okay, these details he is going to tell you. Okay, so the last slide is what's required from you: passion, attitude, good communication skill, analytical skill. That is the only requirement to be a good software tester. Okay, we are starting from the scratch. If you don't know about automation, if you don't know what manual testing is, if you don't know what actually testing is, you get enrolled in this class, you will learn everything from the scratch for the testing. Okay, so that, and the another requirement which I haven't mentioned here, a lot of interaction during the class, like the way every one of you did today. Okay, so with this, Hafiza, this detail Raman sir will be able to give you, which you asked me right now. Okay, so with this I will be closing today's session. I hope it was good, you got to know something from this demo session, and I hope I will see most of you in the next session, which is scheduled on next Saturday. Okay, yes Harinder, I will be providing the study material. Okay, Anurag, any kind of project during the course of the training, you will find different kinds of things we will be doing. For Jira, we will have different kind of project. When I will be telling you about SQL, there will be something different. So it is not something related to automation testing where we will be creating one particular project and we will be doing some kind of all the experiments there. In manual testing, you have to learn various aspects of testing. So there will be different project for API testing, different project for Jira. All these things will be there. Not only single thing, it will not be there. Okay, so I hope I'm clear now. With this, I'm closing today's demo session. Okay, so thank you guys for attending it. All of you were very attentive throughout the class, and I got a lot of questions, and I hope I cleared each and every doubt during the course of training. Have a good day. Thank you so much, guys.